Very good morning. How are you all? Okay, yesterday it was a Sunday, so we enjoyed a lot. And today again it's a Monday. We have to come back with the subject, right? Yes. So I hope everyone had a breakfast. Very good. Sit happily and enjoy my class. Understood? Yes. So last we have completed about the parts of speech and the basics of the homophones. Homonyms, synonyms and antonyms. Is it? Yes, very good. So today, the most important thing we are going to learn is about the letters. So what we are going to learn today? We are going to learn about the letters. So most of us, we already know how to write a letter. Yes or no? So children, before in the olden days, how the people used to communicate? People in the olden days, they used to communicate by drawing it on the walls. Whoever is coming at the back, they are communicating by drawing it on the back. Yes or no? Yes. So I forgot, children, what is the date today? What is the date? 28. Yes. You all should remind. Yes or no? What is the spelling of Monday? Yes. Very good.
Many of them, they forgot to write the
29. Yes, what is that? 29/6/2020. To address and the from address. Now, this is the first step you all should remember. What is this, children? This is the first step you all should remember. What is the first step you all should remember? You have to write the date of year and to address and from address. Okay? The second thing, what is the second thing? Yes, salutation. Actually, what are salutations, children? Salutations means it's a greeting part. What are salutations? Salutations are, or you can say it is a greeting part. Now, greeting part, what is a greeting part and how do we greet each other? For example, when we are writing a letter, after completing this part, the second part is greeting part. You can write, respected sir, or you can write, my dear so and so. My dear so and so. You can start like the good morning, respected sir, or honorable sir. Yes or no? The second part you should start with the greeting. The third one is body of the letter. Third one is what, children? Body of the letter. Now, what is the body of the letter? Does a letter is having a body over here? Does a letter is having a body? No, letter does not have a body. But the body of the letter means when you write it in a paragraph, the message, what you want to convey to him, you have to write it. For example, if it is too long, cut that and make it into two paragraphs. Understood? The body of the letter, what you have to do, if it is too long, cut it and make it into two paragraphs. If not, it's not too long, you can write it in a short paragraph. Understood? The next part is what you read? Body of the letter. Now, what is the fourth part? Fourth part about what you are writing about. For example, you are complaining about a certain thing. Understood? If you are complaining about a certain thing, you have to write it here, the subject. About what you are doing, what do you want, what complaint you are giving. Understood? That particular thing you have to write it here. And the last part is what, children? Last part is, like you say, you write the thanking you, yours obediently or yours faithfully, the signature part. Yes or no, children? The signature part will be the last part. The signature part will be the last part. So I hope you got the formal letter. Formal letters, you have a particular pattern. You have to follow that particular pattern when writing a formal letter. Formal letters, the first thing you all should write is date. It will be in the right hand side. And coming to the next thing, from address and the to address. Okay? To address and the from address. The next part is salutations or the greeting part. Means your greeting. Like respected sir or respected man or my dear friend. Yes or no? So you have to write the greeting part over here. Coming to the third part. Third and the fourth part, children. Either first you can write the subject, then come back to the body of the letter, or you can write the body of the letter, or then come back to the subject. Now here is the body of the letter. When you are writing the body of the letter, the comma and the full stops, wherever it is needed, you have to add it. Understood? Body of the letter, full stop, commas, wherever it is needed, you have to add it. Okay? Next, subject means what are you expecting, or what you're saying, what you're asking for, or if you're giving some other thing, like means what you say that if you're showing him, you have to write the subject over here. The next one is what you write, signature. The last part will be the signature. Understood? The last part will be the signature. Yes, so I hope you all understood what is a formal letter. Formal letter which we write to the higher authorities for asking the leave, or the editor of the local newspapers, or the CMs, to the honorable, the chief guest, who want me to go with the informal letters next? Yes. Yes. Next, it's a informal letter. Now, what are informal letters? Informal letters which are written to our dear ones. To our dear ones means what? Like our friends, our parents, our uncles. Yes or no? To whom we feel they are special, we write the informal letters. Understood, children? The informal letters are the letters which we are used to write to our dear ones, okay, which we are used to write to our dear ones. Those are the informal letters. For this informal letters, there is no particular pattern to follow. I'm already saying here, formal letters you have a particular pattern to follow. When coming to the informal letters, we do not have any particular pattern to follow. You can write as any way, okay. For example, see, I'm writing the date over here. What is the date today? It's a 29/6/2020. Yes or no? The date I'm writing over here in the right hand side. Next, coming here, I'm writing my dear friend. My dear friend, comma, body of the letter. Body of the letter. And after that, there is no subject over here, because whatever you want, you will tell them in a particular paragraph. So when the paragraph is too long, even you can make it as half and half into two paragraphs. And the last one will be yours faithful friend. Yours faithful friend and your signature. So either you can write it this side or that side. Yes or no? Either you can write it this side or that side. So, when coming to the informal letters, there is no need to follow a particular pattern. But when coming to the formal letters, it is very, very important to follow a particular pattern. Understood? Yes. Now you can see the date over there, friend, and then you can write to address and from address. Or even that, you first you can write the from address or to address, and then again you can write it. So there is no particular pattern to follow in the informal letters, but in the formal letters you have to follow the particular pattern. Understood? I hope you all understood about the formal and the informal letters. Yes. Okay. Example, when we are taking a leave, okay? When we are taking a leave, what type of letter we are writing to a principal? Are we writing a formal letter or informal letter? We are writing a formal letter to a principal. Yes or no? Why? Because we are asking him for leave. Yes or no, children? Example, see now, if we write a letter, okay, see, write understood? This letter you should write it like this in this particular thing. Got it? Okay. One more time I'm saying here. How many types of letters we have? Actually, we have formal letters and the informal letters. As I have explained here, the two types of letters we are having: formal letters and the informal letters. Now, what are the formal letters? Formal letters are written to the particular organization authorities, or if you are working in one particular organization, there you are asking him for a leave. Okay, asking him for a leave. So, by coming to the formal letters, we have to follow a particular pattern. When writing a formal letter, what we have to do? We have to follow a particular pattern. Now, what particular pattern we should follow over here? As you know that, as I said, first we will write the date in the left hand side, then to address, from address, then the second part will be children, greetings or salutations. Greetings or salutations. The fourth part will be the body of the letter. Yes or no? Body of the letter. First, this one. Second is greetings or salutations. Third one is body of the letter. Fourth one will be the subject. Fourth one will be the subject about particular thing what you are writing. And fifth one will be the signature part, the leave taking part. You have completed the whole letter. And the last thing is you have to do the signature of yourself. So, by taking this, we have completed the patterns of the letter. Now, informal letters means we do not have any particular pattern to follow. We can write in our own way. Understood? Either you can write the two address, from address at the top, or you can write it at the bottom. There is no issue. Understood, children? So, these letters, I hope you all understood. Yes? Very good. Now, come back to the small moral part of the stories. As I have said, the letter part I have completed for you. Yes? Okay. The first moral of the story we'll learn. Yes, children? Moral of the stories are the most important thing in a life. Yes or no? They are the most important things of a life. Without morals, a person is nothing. Without moral, the person is nothing. So, what moral stories we are learning over here means last time we have learned about the ant and the elephant. Did you all remember? Yes or not? Last time we have learned about the ant and the elephant moral of the story. Yes, children? Last time what story we have learned? We have learned ant and the elephant. So today the dove and the peacock story you are going to learn. What is that, children? Dove and peacock story. You all know what is a dove actually? Yes. It will be like a pigeon. Understood? Dove, it is also be like a pigeon but fully white color with a fluffy feathers. You all know fluffy feathers means beautiful little bee. And what is a peacock? We already know it is a national bird with the whole beauty of the peacock. Yes or no, children? So, these dove and peacock were the best friends. Were the best friends in the jungle. So, suddenly one day, peacock said, I am very proud of my beauty. So, here what the peacock said? That peacock is very proud of her beauty. Is it? Yes or no? Suppose two friends are going. One friend will be thin, one friend will be fat. She is taller, she is short. She is fair and she is dark. So, when the comparison comes here, automatically the fatter, the darker and the shorter gets down. And when she is tall, she is pretty, she is beautiful, it usually goes high. So, here what is the main thing we have learned? That never compare each other. We should not at all compare anyone. They have their own beauty within themselves. Have you all know even we have a beauty within ourselves? We cannot go and show to everyone. Yes or no? We have to create our own beauty. We have to create our own beauty by making our inner feeling strong. You should say, I am beautiful. Whenever you look to yourself, you Understood? Your inner feelings will become more strong. Understood, children? So here we have to never compare each and everyone. Each and everyone has having their own thoughts, own beauty, own talent. Okay? So this is your end of our English class. And the main thing I have forgot to say here about the homework part. Yes, children? Your homework. What will be your homework now for today? Today, your homework. I'm writing it here. English class, and I am taking leave.